I love guns. In fact, a lot of Americans do. An overwhelming amount of Americans do. According to Gallup News, over 44% of Americans own a firearm of some sort. That's about 72 million people. But whether or not you own a gun, you've probably noticed recently that we're having an ammunition shortage, and the ammunition you can find is really expensive. So, what happened? How did this happen? And what's next? Anyways, before we talk about the ammunition shortage, let's first talk about ammunition and what components make up ammunition and why it's so expensive and so forth. So, for this part of the video, I'm going to have my Uncle Edgar explain it to you. He's in the firearms industry and he knows a lot about this stuff. So, without further ado, take it away, Edgar.
So, to first answer the question of why is there an ammunition shortage, let's first talk about what is ammunition. Ammunition is loaded cartridges that are individual cartridges that can be loaded into a firearm and fired. There are different types of cartridges. There are rimfire cartridges, there are pistol cartridges or handgun cartridges, then there's rifle cartridges, and then finally you have a shotgun cartridge or a shotgun shell is what it's referred to. All of these different types of cartridges all have four components in common that make up ammunition. They are the projectile, commonly referred to as bullet, the casing, the primer, and then the powder, the gunpowder or smokeless powder inside that actually propels the cartridge through the barrel.
Now that we know what our basic components for ammunition are, let's now talk about, well, what caused the shortage. And for this, we're gonna have to go all the way back to 2020.
Deadly coronavirus officially hitting the US. Here's what we know. A Washington State resident fell ill after returning from Wuhan, China.
Surged to another record high, topping 1,000 for the first time. This year has thrown so many numbers, but still 10,000 deaths is a complete. And missing has confirmed over 800,000.
Tonight, this evening, more than 900,000 lives have been lost to the virus in this country.
Times, rioters ruled the streets. It's clear the violence is spreading. Right now, multiple buildings on this block are on fire. The National Guard just arrived on the scene. This seems like a dramatic escalation from what we saw the night before.
Breaking news at this hour. CBS News projects that Joe Biden has been elected the 46th president of the United States. The kid from Scranton becomes the next leader of the free world.
My fellow Americans.
Wow. As you can see, 2020 was quite a year. So, let's start where it all began, and probably the thing that packed the most punch when it came to the ammunition shortage, COVID-19. The ongoing COVID-19 virus was raging through the United States and the rest of the world, and with that started a panic. In March of 2020, the World Health Organization finally declared COVID-19 as a pandemic. Mass chaos ensued, naturally, and with that, states started to enforce the stay-at-home rule. People needed a hobby and wanted protection, because these were uncertain times, so they went out and bought a gun. Most of them for the very first time. 3 million guns sold this spring of that year alone, and according to the National Sports Foundation, 5.4 million gun owners were first-time buyers. The first-time buyers bought guns, and with guns, they needed ammunition, and they bought ammunition like crazy. Then the people who actually needed the ammunition went out and bought it and got whatever they could get. The hoarders hoarded, the collectors collected, and the dreamers dreamed. The George Floyd protests in May of 2020 did not help one bit. The public panic due to the riots and protests, many people bought guns and ammunition. The most sold gun was the AR-15, and the most sold caliber was the 9mm. At this point, firearm and ammunition manufacturers are extremely behind on demand,
and the shelves are completely empty. And now the only thing that was predictable that could have caused the ammunition shortage, the presidential election. In 2020, Joseph R. Biden won against Donald Trump in the election. Biden has stated in the past that he supports gun control in ways such as the ammunition capacity limits, reinstilling the federal assault weapon ban, universal background checks, and closing the gun show loophole. Now, you may remember my Uncle Edgar from earlier, how he works in the firearms industry and everything. I got to interview him for this documentary, and well, this is what I asked him.
Alright, let's do this. Alright, so in 2020, we had, you know, the toilet paper shortage and everything like that, but we're still having, or we can still find toilet paper on the shelves. And, you know, there hasn't been as much civil unrest since the death of George Floyd. Why is the ammunition still persistent in price and shortage?
That's a good question. In 2020, the number of firearm sales was 40% higher than it had been in 2019. 40 million guns in the United States were sold. So unlike toilet paper shortage, where toilet paper usage did not go up, the demand went up for it. Now, in the firearms industry, when you're selling more firearms, the actual usage is going up far more than it was for toilet paper, as an example. So 40 million firearms, new firearms into the market creates demand that was not there previously. Of those 40 million guns that were purchased in 2020, 5 million of those, or 12.5%, were new gun buyers. Gun buyers who had never bought a gun before in their life. Where if you have a gun and you buy another gun of the same caliber, you probably have ammunition for that gun already when you bought the gun, so you don't need to buy ammunition at the point of sale. For those new gun buyers, they would not have ammunition at home already. So if you imagine a handgun ammunition that comes in boxes of 50, typically when you buy a gun, you buy one or two boxes of ammo, one to practice with and one to keep for actual protection that you plan on. What was the purchase? The purpose of the purchase of your firearm. So imagine 5 million people, new gun buyers, all buy 100 rounds of ammunition at point of sale in 2020. That's 500 million new cartridges needed in the market. So the demand went way up just because of new gun buyers. Now, 2020 was the largest gun sales per the FBI NICS data than ever previously tracked. And that started tracking that in 1998. 2021 was also a very robust year. It didn't match what 2020 was, but it was a very good year. Every month in 2021 was a decrease typically from the month prior, the year prior in 2020, but it was definitely much increased over 2019, which is the last normal pre-pandemic year. So the amount of guns being sold in the market and the amount of new gun buyers in the market is still going up.
Wow, at this point, firearm and ammunition sales are through the roof, as are the prices for those commodities. The brass and copper that are used to make the projectile and the brass for the cartridge are also through the roof, which also does not help in pricing. In fact, companies were fighting against the United States Mint for copper because the Mint wanted some for pennies and they wanted some for the bullet. Obviously, gun stores couldn't meet with the demand. So I went to my local gun store recently and asked the owner what he thought of the ammunition shortage. He declined to be on camera for the interview, but he gave me this to say. Ammunition at his store has increased in price by 40% in the last year, and ammunition over the last 40 years has risen in over 350% in price. And also, major suppliers are over 2 years deep in back orders.
When do you see the shortage ending?
That's a very good question. The shortage is driven by number one, increased demand, or demand in a peak in purchasing, in a spike in demand. Arms manufacturers and ammunition manufacturers are like any other manufacturer, and they're in business to be profitable. So they don't build ammunition plants, they don't buy ammunition manufacturing machines, and they don't staff those machines to meet demand at peak or spikes. They buy that equipment, they invest in that equipment to operate at maximum efficiency just above a normal demand. If you were to build your company and build your manufacturing plant to operate at a maximum efficiency at peak or spike, when it's not at spike, you'll have idle equipment, idle employees, and you actually lose money. So manufacturers of everything, whether it be toilet paper, cars, arms, or ammunition, will manage their businesses to be profitable at normal demand rates.
And, well, that's it. As of the recording of this video, we're still currently in an ammunition shortage. But there's still a lesson to be learned in all this. Whether it be society, science, politics, we should be able to save up for the future and make sure that we save commodities such as sugar, flour, ammunition. It's all the same in the end. Make sure that we have a healthy amount of it for whenever an event, either foretold or unforetold, comes. And as always, thank you for watching. Keep movie making.